everyone, welcome to Community with MC. This is MC with PACIFICWIDE Real Estate and Mortgage. You are watching Get to Know Our Community. Get to Know Our Community is to recognize, to acknowledge the people who bring so much value to our community to make this world a better place for everyone to live. And today I will introduce to you a very young, very talented and full of energy who do so many things for our community. And today, after you know him, you will find him at every community event. Trust me. And his name is Khang Truong.
Thank you.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. Thank you everyone for tuning in to Community with MC. That was a great introduction. And I don't know if I can live up to what she just said, but my name is Khang and I am the co-owner the CEO of VRSquad Inc. I also founded another community on Facebook, which has over 2,000 members right now, and it's called San Jose Volunteer Outreach. So that is an outreach platform that we're trying to network all the volunteers in San Jose so that they can find opportunities so they can go out there and help people and volunteer for events and things like that. And so currently on that website right now, we have over a few events every week constantly on that group, so people have the opportunity to find volunteer opportunities to go out there and give back to the community. And also currently I'm working for Assemblyman Ashkara, District 27. So for him, I am the field representative. So I go out there, represent him to the community, especially the Vietnamese community in San Jose. And so I go to pretty much all the Vietnamese events to help connect him and our assemblyman with the Vietnamese community and vice versa. The Vietnamese community, if they need to talk to him, they go through me and I can help facilitate that.
Okay, I've been counting. So how many things you do? So first thing, you are founder of VRSquad?
Yes, yeah, VRSquad.
VRSquad. Mm-hmm. So you're running that company.
Yes, and then I run another platform to help volunteering groups.
What do you call that?
So it's San Jose Volunteer Outreach, SJVO.
Okay, San Jose Outreach.
San Jose
Volunteer Outreach. Yeah.
And then I work for the Assemblyman.
Assemblyman. So right. Three jobs.
Right.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
That's it?
And
one more thing, right?
this is just a part of that volunteer group.
Oh, I see. Okay, yeah. Then we talk more about it. So I want to ask a little bit more.
Yeah.
When you run VRSquad, can you tell people what it is? Because mm-hmm. I know a lot of people know what it is, what you do, but some people might not know. So can you please talk about the VRSquad for the audience?
Okay, so VRSquad, what we do is we want to use the new technology of 3D modeling of homes to help real estate agents or builders show the 3D model so that the clients don't have to go to the property to view a property. So when they can view it in that way, it's better for them to make a decision on buying or even saving them time. And that's what I really, my goal in everything that I do is to help people being more productive. And so human production is a limited quantity. And so if anything I can do to help people save a lot of time, that's what I want to do. So imagine right now, I mean, for most of the people, buyer, seller, agents, they have to go to a property to do an open house, for example. We waste a lot of time driving around or stuck in traffic, and they see the photos on the websites. They don't have to.
They look at your 3D mm-hmm. video, they don't have to go there and look at the
exactly.
property themselves.
Yeah,
they can just sit at home and see it, right?
Right, so it's a virtual reality tour. So we have these goggles, you can walk in there and you can look around the house. And so that's for the people that live here. They save time from driving. What if the people is from another state? What if the person is from Vietnam, or in China, they can just view that and see the property over here. And that's what we're trying to save people time and money that way.
So you work with a lot of real estate agents.
Yes.
To help them to make the video of the property before they list it for sale.
Right.
So whoever lists a house and need that service, they contact you directly, right?
Yes.
For that service.
Yes. And yeah. So more than just the VR, we also make videos. We make commercials. We make agent commentary, agent testimonials. We take videos of events, and we also do photography for homes. So regular photography, drone photography, flying in the air with the drone. And then we also do event photography. We do twilight, so night shooting photography also.
Wow, that's awesome. So are you the only group doing that in the Bay Area, or there is other group?
No, there are other groups that does it, but in a different way. So we trying to keep our quality. So we train our own people. A lot of people, they want to get big. What they do is they contract out to other people. Mm-hmm. So they have another contractor, so another pro photographer working for them. But they cannot have the control of the quality of that photographer.
What we
do is we train our own guys. Mm. So anything that we're gonna do is from our own people.
So it basically kind of tell me why people should choose you instead of other service, because you have you control the quality.
Yeah.
So whoever come to you would only get the best quality of the video, the product, right?
Exactly. So the reason why people should choose us is because we have a one-stop shop for everything that they need.
Okay.
So if they're gonna go to, and again, the story again is saving people time, right?
Okay.
The realtor.
Okay.
So the realtor, if they need a video, they have to go to one guy. They go to a photographer for another guy, and then they need some marketing online, they go to a different company.
Okay.
Well, we do all that in one.
Okay.
And so there's not a lot of companies out there that does the whole packaging one, especially with the 3D models, the VR.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So now I would like to talk about the foundation, the volunteer outreach.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell me a little bit about it? Like, when did you start having the...
I started that 3 years ago when I got out of college.
What school did you go to?
So I went to UC Davis. I graduated as a biochem, molecular biology.
I was from there.
Mm-hmm.
UC Davis.
Yeah, go Aggies.
Leon. And Leon was from there too.
Awesome. Go Aggies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway,
to all the Aggies out there.
Awesome. Okay, so after you're done with your school, you came out and you create a volunteer foundation, outreach right away?
So the story is that when I graduate, I was pre-med. So I was trying to go to med school.
Wow.
So before that, I already took the MCAT and everything already. So that 1 year is my 1 year off, you know, before you apply. And in that year, I started my volunteering work since I was very young. So em là từ gia đình Phật tử, right? So I do a lot of Vietnamese community work.
Wow.
So starting very young, I already volunteered myself to do like mua lăng hay là làm từ thiện cho for Buddhist churches and things like that.
Wow.
So I did the same thing in college. So I did, you know, like the cancer awareness, you know. My wife and I actually walked 100 laps in the pavilion, right, at UC Davis.
Oh, I see.
To fundraise about $50,000 for cancer research.
Wow,
right?
That's awesome.
And so
when you was in school.
Oh yeah, when
you
I was
started
in school.
Very young, and then you do it all the way up.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I think that's something. What we believe is we give the little things that we can do. It doesn't matter if you're gonna wait until if you're rich, then you can give. Then that's too late, you know. And who would think that if you can do something when you're down here, what makes you think that you're gonna start doing something when you're up here? So I do what I can as I go.
That's awesome.
So the volunteering is I started with Vivo. So Wing Mai, he is very big in the community, and he does a lot of stuff for the Vietnamese community, and that's why I went and volunteered for him. To help him run the THUD event 3 years ago.
I was there. I was involved in that event.
I didn't meet you back then. Oh, really? I just barely came back, so I'm very new. And there's a lot of people there, so you probably didn't recognize me.
Plus, I'm small and ugly, so. No, that's not true.
I started then. And so with that base of volunteer, I create this group so I can connect more kids to opportunities in San Jose. And I think that's just a great group to help people, to get more people involved. Mm. I believe that by one person, we cannot do very much.
Right, that's right.
Right, but if we can, each of us, ask another person to start doing the smallest thing to help other people,
right,
where eventually we'll get everyone to add a little bit. And when they give a little bit, they see, oh, what more can I do?
Right.
So Wing actually did that to me. And I believe I can transfer that to the next person.
So Wing
does a lot for the community. And when I work under him, I learn that, oh, now I can do more. So that's why I started more. And like this event, I started 2 years ago. And the first year I thought,
Let's talk about this event. Sorry. Can you go and yeah. So before we go to this event, let's do this. So your foundation, your San Jose Outreach, you started 3 years ago. And normally, what do you do for the community? You use that organization to organize some kind of event, something like.
So we connect the volunteer there, and then we search for opportunities out there that look for volunteers.
Right?
So, for example, Ting Tam Charity, or they have a lot of different charities out there.
I see.
When those charities need help,
then you come and you help them. Wow, that's really nice.
But we don't facilitate that because there's too much work in that.
I
see that, hey, you need people, come onto our page and ask on there.
I see.
So the more people start joining to add people, they just do it like automatically without us involved.
I see.
And that's what we want to do. So now that website has over 2,000 people on there and a lot of volunteers
What
on
is
there.
The website name?
It's SJVO, San Jose Volunteer Outreach.
SJVO.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good to know.
Yeah. So I'll add you on the group.
Okay, that's good. Please do.
Yeah.
So I understand that your San Jose Volunteer Outreach is organizing second time. Last year you organized one. It's called Thanksgiving Charity, right?
Yeah.
Thanksgiving Charity.
Yeah. So we started this. How I started this was 3 years ago. So I read the book by Tony Robbins.
Oh, I love that guy.
Yeah. So I was really inspired by him because he said that someone helped him during Thanksgiving. And so he started giving back by feeding one family and then two family. And now he feeds millions of families, right? And I'm like, okay, that's great. I'm gonna do that too, right? I'm gonna start this year by feeding one family. So I started feeding one family, and when I thought of feeding one family, why do you have to do, I leverage other people,
right?
That's so awesome. My only resource is if I'm gonna put $100, that's not gonna do much good. But if my skill is to get people to help me or connect people, then I should get more people involved, and then that's how I fundraise $2,000 instead of $100 to feed one.
So you feed a lot more now. So hello everyone. So this year, we at PACIFICWIDE really happy that we worked with Khang on this project, and we also see that the Lee Sandwich and another company.
Goal is actually a student organization at San Jose State.
They volunteer
on a lot of volunteer
work. That's good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So Khang now not feeding one family, together with other group, we're going to feed a lot more this year. And the event going to happen on November 24th this year, November, so 3 weeks, two, 3 weeks from now. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be at St. James Park, 100 North 1st Street. So as you understand that we will need a lot of help and donation in order to feed more families. And as I understand that you will give out care kits, right? Yeah. In the package, you're gonna give out to each family a package which have flashlight, socks, poncho, gloves, a lot of products like toothpaste, a lot of things. So, and I understand it costs $20 a bag.
Right.
So if anyone out there want to, together with us, to help, to give out more, you can only join us by donation. $20 per family, per person, not per family.
It's up to the person, but that's only for one kit. So one the kit. Reason why we did this is that we make it very small and easy for people to get involved. They can get involved. So last year we have one donor that gave $1,000. But you don't have to give $1,000. We don't ask you to give any money at all, actually. We ask you to come out, bring your kids, bring your family, and just show the homeless people out there that there's love out there, right? People actually care. They're gonna be there. So just being there actually is what we ask. We don't ask for money.
Oh, okay.
But if you do gonna willing to give, you can give one care kit, which is only $20.
Right.
Which is very easy to do. And that is the small steps that I'm talking about for people to start giving is you don't have to give big. You can just give the smallest amount.
And yesterday when I talked to my sister-in-law, mm-hmm. and she a dentist, mm-hmm. and she live up in Sacramento, and her company is Alhambra Dentist. Yes. And she told me, can she donate toothpaste and toothbrush?
Oh yeah, of course.
So
yeah.
You would take, because she said that she don't know how much we need.
Mm-hmm.
If we need a lot, mm-hmm. she can go to different dental office and mm-hmm. ask for it. So she will be able to donate a lot of those. So just want to let you know, so you don't have to buy toothpaste and toothbrush in this case.
Oh, nice.
So we're gonna.
We already ordered it, because the sooner we order it, the cheaper it is to order. But we can always use more. So we
okay,
already ordered
more. We can put more in
right.
there.
So we
them
already
yes.
ordered 100 kits for this year. That's what we're prepared for.
We're gonna have more. We're gonna have more. So everyone, if you wanna donate anything, you contact us to see what we need so that we can donate. Like my sister-in-law gonna donate toothpaste and toothbrush. So the more we give, the more package we can give out, right? If you donate, and if you don't have time to buy stuff, you can donate money.
Yes.
We can put them together and give it to the homeless. And as you said, if somebody waiting until you're rich to give, how do you define rich?
Right.
And when are you consider yourself rich,
exactly.
right? It's a really,
exactly.
it's a very hard definition.
It's relative, right? to the person yes. at times.
And I also learned, actually, I listened to a lot of DVD tape and books like you.
Yeah.
And I learned one thing. There's one person he told in the video, he said, if you have $1, can you give 50 cents? If you have $10, can you give $2, $5? You don't need to have $100,000 to give some money.
Exactly.
So yeah. if you don't have a lot of money, just give a little bit. Because
mm-hmm.
that, it really, from your heart, it's not how much you give, it's how much you love.
Mm-hmm.
So I really expect, actually, when I talk about this, I would like to have people involved with us. I want more people involved in the community work to show the people around us that we care.
Mm-hmm.
That's all, it's about love and care. It's all about love and care again. So please, I will have the information how to donate, how to volunteer on my underneath my video later on.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have anything to add before we go? So the student who in a high school who want to volunteer, they can bring the form.
Yes.
It's called community service credit.
Right.
We can sign for
we
them,
can
sign
right? them off. Uh-huh.
They can get some credits for
right.
doing this. So
right.
please come as a whole family.
Mm-hmm.
Help your kids come out to help the community. I think they love to do that, because over the past weekend, I did that with my family and my children. They had a good time.
Mm-hmm.
They brought their friends and cousin. It was a good time.
Right. Yeah. So again, yeah, definitely bring your young kids, because to learn to give, you start very small, and the smaller, you know, they feel good doing it. And you know, just, you don't have to give money or anything, you just have to come out there. But just like you said earlier, you know, if you have a dollar, can you give 50 cents, right? So it's really not the amount of giving that you do, but it's really the thought. And like I said, you don't even have to give money. You just have to be out there.
Be out there.
Just being there counts, right? Just showing people the love that you care.
So one last question for you. Because I see that you get involved a lot in the community. You do a lot of volunteer work. What inspire you most for all that, for doing all that?
What inspire? I would say I read a lot of books and I'm inspired by people like Ji Minzhou here, or people like An Leon.
Thank you.
They're very similar to me, right? I mean, I don't know about other people, but I do know Vietnamese. It's tough for us to leave our country, come over here, and to start over, to start over from nothing. And if they come here and at an older age too, like me, I came here when I was younger, it's easier. But for older people, like my parents, they overcome all of that and they still make something great. So that shows me the ability in people, and I'm inspired by people who makes things happen. So I mean, you guys are successful in my opinion.
Oh, thank you.
And I think you guys are great by giving back to the community. And so, I'm inspired by just people like you. Yeah.
And I'm inspired by you. Because you are so young and you always think of other people. I really appreciate it. And I think I need more people like you. That's why I have this show. This show is to inspire people, to motivate them to do good things. So I want people, when they watch this show, they want to do what you do. Like start volunteering since you were little and continue doing it until now. You do more.
Yeah.
You have experience, so you can help a lot more people. Yeah. And I really appreciate it. And I look forward to work with you on more and more community service and community projects.
Yeah,
I love to.
Yeah.
And thank you so much again for being here today. And do
thank you
want to have anything to say?
No, I actually don't. But yeah, thank you for tuning in. And hope to see you guys at the Give Thanks event.
That's it.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Great talk.
Good job. Thank you, MJ. Good job.